Greetings everyone, this is Sayed Reza Mashhadi and I'm going to start session 4 of electrical resistivity tomography ERT from 0 to hero. And in this session we're going through pseudo-section versus inverted model. At first I'm going to describe what pseudo-section is. So to be able to do so, we had a brief discussion in the last session. I will start with a briefing about last session. Then I will discuss the pseudo-section and I will bring some examples for different arrays to see that the pseudo-section is different for different arrays over identical structures, and it is important to know. And in the end, I will discuss and quickly review that how a section or an inverted model or an inverse model is different from pseudo-section. This will be the basis to start concepts like forward modeling and inverse modeling, and then going through the inversion procedures in Resistivity software. So in the last session we discussed how we can calculate power resistivity values by having measured resistance values in the field, and then we understand the meaning of a power resistivity concept. We know that a power resistivity is the resistivity of a homogeneous half a space that would be measured with the same electrodes configuration, and it is not the true resistivity value of subsurface materials. So the pseudo-section which uses apparent resistivity values will not provide us sections of subsurface. And we heavily discussed the x, y, and z coordinates of each data point's location in the pseudo-section. Especially we discussed the depth of investigation concept and the effective depth of investigation concept proposed by Edwards 1977. So I just want you to remember that how we discuss x and y and z coordinates of each data point in the pseudo-section and what were the rules of thumb to do this. So with this introduction, now we know that the pseudo-section doesn't have in fact a clear explanation or a clear definition, but we can probably describe it as a procedure to plot measured apparent resistivity data by means of several rules of thumb. For example, considering the mean value of x coordinates of active electrodes, or so doing it for y also, and having the median depth of investigation. And it is in fact just a procedure to plot the measured apparent resistivity data and probably see somehow qualitative way that what would be the how and what would be the shape of the scanned subsurface, up to what depths of we have scanned the subsurface, for example. And it is, I say that it is qualitative because we have other measures like the DOI, that it is probably you can refer it to the Dr. Course looks for in the end pages of this to describe the areas that have been scanned by electrical resistivity tomography. But now just take this that the pseudo-section is just providing us a measure to see very extremely noisy data points, or probably it is just a way to see several profiles together, the profiles of same depth of investigation character, there's a depth of investigation, pseudo depths, in fact, and the profile, the vertical variations are in each location. The concept of pseudo-section will be very difficult and to analyze and understand, especially if we're just looking at the combined data sets of different arrays. So let's just consider the simple arrays and single arrays in a data set and consider that this is just a plotting procedure to just visualize the data in a way to find out extremely noisy data points or so. And why it is like this, because as I have said in previous sessions, each electrical measurement is affected by 3D volume of subsurface materials. And it is important, and it is in fact inherently not a point measurement like a geochemical assay or, you know, a sample at the surface. And it is affected by a volume of subsurface materials, three dimensions, in three dimensions, so it will not be a good option to, you know, relate one point and say that the 3D volume is not, you know, very good idea to do it, and it is just a measurement of one single point. I will describe as an example in here to see it more clearly. This is what would be the n equals 2 for the dipole-dipole array, C1, C2, P1, P2. And this is the very old method for the 45-degree diagonals. And you see that location would be the cross-cutting diagonals coming from potential and current electrodes. And if you plot this, you know, methodology in here, in the sensitivity section of the dipole-dipole array for n equals 2, you will see that the location of the data point will be this black star. And if you look at this, you will see that much of the area with very high sensitivities are just close to the electrodes, and we just assume a number of the measurement to a location which is very less affected by the measurement, in fact. So this is the 45-degree diagonals method for pseudo-section plotting, and this location is the Z of the median, or the effective depth of investigation, which is used in Resistivity software and most of the software that, you know, plot pseudo-sections as well. So and even in this point, you will see that much of the areas with very high positive or very high negative sensitivities is, you know, not taken into consideration if we just say that this is it, this measurement would be presented at this point. So totally, the use of pseudo-section in any kind of interpretation is just a very wrong idea, and I would emphasize on this, and I have and I have done this you know, presentation mostly because of this, because I saw that some people are just taking into consideration whenever they are analyzing ERT datasets. So the pseudo-section is just a plot to see the data and not more than that. And why? Because even for a similar structure, we will have different pseudo-sections for different arrays. This is what I have calculated myself, and I'm going to show you how it is done in next videos. And you will see, and it is also a model that is present in the Dr. Luke course materials from at geotomosoft.com. In the download section, you can find that tutorial, which is very amazing. And if you look at this resistive body in a conductive medium, and what would be the apparent resistivity values, and we have just used the pseudo-sections, and you will see for the dipole-dipole array, or pole-dipole, or equatorial pole-dipole-dipole, pole-pole, and, you know, Wenner or Wenner, Wenner gamma, Wenner beta, or Wenner alpha, which is also Wenner, called also as Wenner. So you see that the variations are vast, and we cannot in fact insist on using pseudo-sections as a, you know, as even a complementary layer for proposing interpretations, as it is extremely variable. You see, for example, in Wenner gamma array, in this location which the resistive body occurred, is we have very low resistivity values. And, you know, the shape of the anomalies are too much different in different arrays, and it is totally different with respect to the real model. And I will, you know, also insist that the similarity between the, you know, structure of this model, synthetic model with this equatorial dipole-dipole or the pole-pole doesn't guarantee that these arrays are the most effective arrays for analyzing these kind of targets. And we should consider a lot of other parameters that in the future I will also create a video regarding the characteristics of different arrays. You can also find it in detail through the paper, I think, by Bing and Zhu in 2004. They have discussed the characteristics of different arrays in detail. It is very great. I advise you to have a look at it. So this is an example. So let's make the model a bit complicated, and you see that the variations would be severe. So for example, in this example, I created a relatively conductive overburden, and within this we have two inhomogeneities, and then another resistive area, another resistive block at depth, and you will see that it is completely amazing to see these amazing different results. And probably a reason that this model is not very affected in the model because it lies very deep in the represented model. So I will discuss the use of Res2D merge software in the next video. So we will be able to use these models. So I just wanted to show you that, whether the model is not very complicated, we can have very diverse responses by different arrays. So do not pay attention to the pseudo section, and it is just a way to see the data and to probably highlight very high noisy data at your data points, or just to have a comparison between what the the forward modeling of the estimated true resistivity is providing you with respect to your field measurements. I will discuss about it more. So pseudo section is just a way of data plotting procedure and not more than that. So how we get the true resistivity values? We get this through the process called inversion or inverse modeling procedure, and by that we can actually have true resistivity values and the true structures and the true geology, probably based on an estimated true resistivity values from apparent resistivity measurements. So apparent resistivity measurements are taken as the input, and we use some procedures and we estimate what would be the configuration of the resistivity values in the subsurface to provide that measured apparent resistivity, and that will give us the model. So the inverted or inverse model, despite the pseudo section, it provides nearly an exact picture of subsurface. It needs a much more detailed explanation, and that I will go through in next sessions. And in the next session, we will focus on forward modeling procedure, and we will use Res2D mode software to create synthetic electrical resistivity datasets. Thank you for listening. The next session title will be 2D forward modeling of resistivity data with Res2D mode software. If you have any questions, you can email me at the email address below, and thank you for listening.